As we start the ceremony, we'd like to invite Rabbi Yisrael Nachman to sing the Mi Adir. For the Birkas Kohanim, we invite all our priests to come through. Shragi, the father of the Kala, to give the bride and groom the priestly blessings. All the Kohanim from the priests. Beautiful, thank you so much for the reading of the Rebbe's letter to Chasan and Kala, eliciting the Rebbe's blessing as they start their new life on this most auspicious day. We'd like to invite, seen for the very first time in many, many months, our Rav Gafni Shlita to come read the Rebbe's letter.
Rav Gafni!
Translation letter what we just read. I'd like to invite Rabbi Gorenstein, Rosh Yeshiva, Yeshiva Tamim Ederach.
By the grace of God, Brooklyn, New York, greetings and blessings. I reply to your notification of the day of your wedding to take place with God's help. I send herewith my prayerful wishes that it take place in a happy and auspicious hour, and that you build an everlasting Jewish home based on the foundations of the Torah and Mitzvahs, as they are illuminated with the inner light of the Torah.
Amen. We start the ceremony of Kiddushin, the sanctifying Yeshua to Tamar, bringing forth this union. He just explained in the Maamar of Lecha Dodi Dikatkara, Pnei Shabbat Mekabra. Fulfill this full union here below, starting with the external physical action into the full union, uniting and being the example to unite the Shekhinah and the Jews together. We invite Rav Pasternak to come to be the officiating rabbi to marry off this young, beautiful couple. And I'd like to call the two witnesses, Shlomo Gotzi and Ephraim.
Mazel tov, mazel tov. Permission to say a few words. First of all, good people topics, as the family just told us. In general, when you have a wedding, when you say the Rebbe's Maamar, all of the Rebbeim have come to your wedding, along with your ancestors, along with your future generations, not just family should be. And the Rebbeim come, and they're here with us. That's in every wedding. But when the Rebbeim come on Yud Gimel Tammuz, the Rebbeim come for bringing. And the Rebbeim are not down there for bringing, they're Yud Gimel Tammuz for bringing. And they're bringing Hebrew Torah and the Torah Chadash Miti, they say, it's pouring over us right now in ways we can't imagine. I want to bring out one point, which I always like to see this stuff across and things, and sometimes over the head. We want to point out that this couple got engaged on Gimel Tammuz, and just 10 days later they're getting married on Yud Gimel Tammuz, which I think is a copyright. I don't think it happened. It's an amazing thing. It's a great idea. Why don't most people do it? Because it's quick. 10 days. But what's amazing is that we actually learn together. We have classes. We learn together with the Chassid and Kala. We learn a Gimel Tammuz from the Rebbe. He explains what Gimel Tammuz is and its connection to Yud Gimel Tammuz. It's unbelievable. What he explains over there is that, first of all, Gimel Tammuz is the beginning of the redemption of the Jewish Rebbe. As it's known, it's Chal to the Geula. Because from that day, he was taken out of prison and put in exile. It was supposed to be a 10-year exile, then he got turned into a 3-year exile. Lo and behold, 9 days later, he was there on the 12th of Tammuz, which was Shabbos, okay, which is not unbelievable. That you're also when you're based Tammuz, you have your wedding on Gimel Tammuz. So on the Yud based Tammuz, they told the Rebbe he was going to be free, and on Yud Gimel Tammuz, they made him free in the official books of that country. The Rebbe asked a simple question. We're seeing here a miracle which is completely beyond nature, the freeing of enemy number one in the eyes of the Russians, which is Tzadik Hador. They had him in their clutches and they freed him. And it was a miracle beyond nature. If that's the case, why did it have to come about that the miracle took place in a natural way? Remember, we learned this. First, they let him out of prison into exile. And then from exile, then there was another process that they gave him to go ahead, but he wasn't official yet. And the next day was official. And the Rebbe goes on, 60 years later is when this miracle actually finished happening, when the Iron Curtain fell and all the Jews left Russia. That was the real result of this miracle. The Rebbe asked a question, if it's such a miracle beyond nature, why did it have to go through this process? Why'd it have to be first this and then that? It shouldn't be developing in a natural way. It should have been supernatural from the beginning. But the Rebbe says it's going to teach us a very deep lesson. And that is that there has to be a marriage between the supernatural and the natural. And these two, and this, not only there has to be such a marriage, but this marriage of the supernatural and HaKadosh Baruch. And the Kala is this is the sphere of Malchus. Right? And so you're marrying Mamish heaven and earth together. The symbol of this, as the Rebbe points out, is the staff of Aaron that miraculously sprouted, and simultaneously as it sprouted in all of its stages. First from bud, and then flower and bud, and then fruit. And the Jewish people were shown all these stages in order to show us that there was, and this staff of Aaron remains in existence today, buried under the Har HaBayis as an eternal symbol of the marriage of supernatural and natural, the Birchas Kohanim. The names of the Chassan and Kala are mamish. You couldn't write this in a script. Yeshua Hashem Kerifayim. When it comes to the swiftness of the miracle, which is above nature, it says that Yeshua Hashem Kerifayim, instantaneously, the miracle beyond nature. Together with that, Tzadik Katamar Yifrach, that there should be a tree that grows naturally and slowly in all of its processes, and these two things have to come together and marry each other. And that's what they're doing. They're not just I'm doing it. Gimel Tammuz and Yud Gimel Tammuz, which is the symbol of the swiftness of miracle coming into a process of nature, mamish, like you wrote it in a script. So we want to wish you a mazel tov, and the Rebbeim are here for bringing with us, giving us the biggest brachas and mazel tov that can be. I got my book. Are we going to fill up the?
Hey, at the Kodeshet Li, the Shabbat Zo, the Moshe Vissar. reading of the Ketubah, I'd like to invite Yoel Tojman.
Ano fela veoy kiu beizon e faner si zoch lechem karuchas gobin yudoy de palchin umolchin mezanin u fanesin el shon be kushtu be adino le kaiset es vosse zuze meyo de posi lechem in rabonon u mezon lechem tsu zu sebe si kukochi vi helo busich et oiro kol a gobe tsvias moros tama et asto do vavas ler anso be din de dunyo anolos le mevi o goben be kaiset ben bezog בן בתפשיטים, למען הדלבושו, בשימוש הדירו, בשימוש הדארסו, הכל קובל אולוב, יהושע מיכואל חוסן דונות, בחמישים שקוקים כסף שו בצבי יהושע מיכואל חוסן דונות, ועושים לו מן דלה עוד חמישים שקוקים כסף, שובוף אחרים כנגדום, סך הכל מאה שקוקים כסף, שובוף, וכך אומר יהושע מיכואל חוסן דונות, אך יהושע תקסבוסו דודדוניו, Don Vesutoto, the Kabulos, Olai, and the Russian Sassel, Tommy Korsfeld, Alag, the Hosin, the Kinyonin, the Iset, Azut Korsmayo, the Kano, the Acid, Ono, the Mikno, the Hosin, the Iskona Haris, the Delis, the Oda Kayus, Elhon, Yeho, Akain, Barbin, the Poyaminaon, Tarak Suboso, Don Inunio, Din Vesutoto, Do, Rafilum in Primo, the Akbu Bechaim, and Son Kaim in Yoimo. Den anul olom ach yus bechoy mir shtak tsvoso. Don du yo do in vesotepto do kabel olom. Yo so mi khol khos an den un khoy mir kol shit hak tsvos. Vesotes vos nagin be vos is swel. As du in ke tsikon khosal. De lo ke as kam yo de lo ke tu se ke shtad de kinyono. Man yo so mi khol ben yo is zem. Khos an den un magas tomo vas don akoyen. Itos do al kol madikosu. ומפורש ליל, ומונו דקול של מקדובו, הכל שריר וקיום. ועדים, נאו יצחוק מיר בן יואל הכהן, נאו מערכות העד השני שולם בן בן ציון.
The blessings of the Sheva Bracha is bringing down the infinite circular light into number seven, into the nature, like our Pastor Nak said, bringing the supernatural within the natural world. I'd like to invite Father of the Kala, Dan, for the first two blessings. The third blessing, we invite Rabbi Alon Rome. Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam yotzer ha'adam.
Amen.
Fourth blessing, writing, relative of the Hassan, Guy Ruveni.
Guy Ruveni.
The fourth blessing.
Guy
אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר יצר את האדם בצלמו בצלם דמות תבניתו והתקין לו ממנו בניין עדי עד ברוך אתה אדוני יוצר האדם
for the blessing number 5 Amsta, we invite Moshe Shweki.
Sos Tassis Betagel Hakara. מקיבוץ פניהם לתוכה בשמחה ברוך אתה אדוני משמח ציון בבניה
אמן
Blessing number 6, we'd like to invite one and only Chaim and Druzia. Wow.
Wow.
Samach to Samach, Reim Ahuvim, Kisamech Yitzircha, Kisamech Echa Yitzircha, Began Eden Mikedem, Baruch Ata Adonai, משמח חוסון וחלום. The last bracha, Rosh Hashanah. Let's invite.
He had to shear.
Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Bara Sason Vesimcha Chatan Vechala Gila Rina Ditsa Vechadva Ahava Vechva Shalom Vereut Mehera Adonai Eloheinu Yishama Be'are Yehuda Uvechutzot Yerushalayim Kol Sason Ve'kol Simcha Kol Chatan Ve'kol ניצלות חתנים מחופתם ונערים ממשתה נגינתם ברוך אתה אדוני משמח חתן עם הקלה
Oh, my God.